In this video, we're going to continue on with our previous worksheet. However, in this section, we're going to be evaluating expressions. You can find this worksheet within the Basics section under the Algebra 2 tab on the CUDA software website. I'll leave a link in the description below so you know how to access this free worksheet. Let's get started with number 13. In number 13, we have y plus z plus 2, and we're using y as negative 6 and z as a positive 5. So if y is equivalent to negative 6, we're going to plug negative 6 in for y. And if z is equal to 5, that means within our expression, z takes on the value of 5. So as opposed to having y plus z plus 2, we will have negative 6 plus 5 plus 2, since y is equal to negative 6 and z is equal to a positive 5. Then evaluate. Negative 6 plus 5 is going to be negative 1, and we're adding 2 to that. So we did negative 6 plus 5 first, and now we'll have negative 1 plus 2, which is equal to a positive 1. So 1 is our solution in number 13. In number 14, we're going to plug negative 6 in for p. However, there's not just one p, there are two p's. So negative 6 will go here and here, and then we're plugging negative 3 in for q. So we'll have negative 6 times negative 3 divided by 3 minus a negative 6. And then we'll just use order of operations, PEMDAS, evaluating what's within the parentheses first. And remember, this set of parentheses is just to separate the operation from the negative. So we're subtracting a negative here. So my first step, I'm going to divide negative 3 divided by positive 3. So I have negative 6 outside my parentheses, and that's multiplied by negative 3 divided by 3, which is negative 1. And then I'm subtracting negative 6, but subtracting a negative, we can write as adding a positive. Next, I'll evaluate negative 1 plus 6. So I'll have negative 6 multiplied by negative 1 plus 6, which is a positive 5. Negative 6 times 5 is equal to a negative 30. So negative 30 is my solution in number 14. In number 15, I'm plugging 1 in for x, and there are two x's, and I'm plugging 6 in for z, and there's only one z. So I'll have 6 divided by 6 plus 1 plus 1 minus 5. So I'll start with my division. I'll divide 6 by 6. 6 divided by 6 is 1, so I'll have plus 1 plus 1 minus 5. 1 plus 1 is 2, and I have to add 1 and then subtract 5. 2 plus 1 is 3, and then I'm subtracting 5. 3 minus 5 equals a negative 2. So negative 2 is my solution in number 15. And again, I did 1 plus 1 to get 2, and then I did 2 plus 1 to get 3. And 3 minus 5 results in a negative 2. In number 16, I'm plugging 6 in for x, I'm plugging negative 5 in for y, and I have another variable, 2, that I'm plugging in for z. So I'll have 6 times 2 plus 3 plus 1 plus 3, and then we're subtracting a negative 5. Evaluating what's inside the parentheses first, I'll do 2 plus 3. So I'll have 6 times 2 plus 3, which will be 6 times 5. And then I'm adding that to 1 plus 3 minus a negative 5, which is the same as adding a positive 5. Next, I have to evaluate my multiplication, 6 times 5. 6 times 5 is 30, and I'm adding that to 1 plus 3 plus 5. And since I have addition all left, the order in which I add doesn't matter. So I'll go ahead and add 30 to 1, and then I'll add 3 to 5 and add those together. So 30 plus 1 is 31, and I'm adding that to 3 plus 5, which is 8. 31 plus 8 results in 39. So my expression evaluated in number 16 is equal to 39. In number 17, I have that p is equal to a positive 1, so I'm plugging 1 in for P, and I have that Q is also equal to 1, so I'm plugging 1 in for Q. That will be 6 plus 1 plus 5 minus 1 minus 1 plus 15. Evaluating what's in parentheses first, I'll do 1 minus 1. So I'll have 6 plus 1 plus 5 minus 1 minus 1, which is 0, plus 15. 6 plus 1 is 7. I'm adding 5, subtracting 0, and then adding 15. 7 plus 5 is 12, so I'll have 12 minus 0, and then I'm adding 15. 12 minus 0 is just 12, so 12 plus 15 will equal 27. So 27 is my solution for number 17. And lastly, for evaluating our expressions, number 18. 1 is equal to A, so I'm plugging 1 in for A, and there's two A's within my expression. B is equal to negative 6, so I'm plugging negative 6 in for B. And lastly, C is equal to negative 4, so I'm plugging negative 4 in for C. I'll have negative 3 divided by 3 times 1 plus negative 4 times negative 6 plus 5 minus negative 6 plus 1. So I'm evaluating what's inside my innermost parentheses first. So here are my outer parentheses, and here are my inner parentheses. So I'll go ahead and evaluate the operations within each of those in the same step, since they are separate. So I'll have negative 3 divided by positive 3 times 1 plus negative 4 times negative 6 plus 5 is a negative 1, and we're subtracting that from negative 6 plus 1, which is a negative 5. My next step will be to evaluate my multiplication within my parentheses, negative 4 times negative 1. So I'll have negative 3 divided by a positive 3 times 1 plus negative 4 times negative 1, which is a positive 4, and minus a negative 5 is the same as adding a positive 5. Now I need to finish evaluating what's inside of my parentheses. My only operation left is addition, so I'll do this all at once. Negative 3 divided by 3 times 1 plus 4 is 5, plus 5 is 10. So I'll have negative 3 divided by 3 times 10. So now remember, the order in which you multiply or divide doesn't matter. However, we must go from left to right. With that being said, I'm going to evaluate negative 3 divided by 3 first and then multiply by 10. Negative 3 divided by a positive 3 is a negative 1, and that's going to be multiplied to 10. Negative 1 times 10 is negative 10. So my solution in number 18 is negative 10. Now, it was very critical for us to divide and then multiply, working from left to right. If we multiplied first, we would get a completely different answer, since 3 times 10 is 30, and negative 3 divided by a positive 30 will result in a fraction. So just remember, even though the order in which you multiply or divide doesn't matter, you have to evaluate operations from left to right. So division in this case came before multiplication. Continue on to the next video, where I'll finish out this worksheet by simplifying algebraic expressions. And before you continue on to the next video, please remember to like this one and go ahead and subscribe to my channel. If you have any comments, please feel free to leave them below.